Hey Diamonds, it's your girl Eva Tarae right back in the saddle with yet another video. If you're a newbie with us today, welcome, welcome, welcome. Please considering subscribing, hit that like button, smash that notification bell, become a part of the Diamond Squad so you'll know as soon as I drop another video. Especially if you like DIYs, makeup tutorials, you know, updates on sister locks, all that jazz. So I'm going to, as you can see by the thumbnail, going to do my DIY pedicure. And I just wanted to come on really quick just to give you guys a sneak peek of some of the products that I do like to use that are noteworthy. Like this pedi scrub. I love it, love it, love it. I purchased this back in March of last year because of the pandemic, and it definitely works. Love this stuff to death. The Dr. Teal's tea bath. Oh my gosh, so relaxing. Those hard days at work. Y'all got to try it. Y'all got to try it. One more thing. This is like a pedicure pack. It's also like a facial pack too. But when you open it, the case, look, you get a whole bunch of things. Nail files, nail clippers, pimple poppers, like all types of stuff. Clean up under your nails, cuticle cutters, all that jazz. I did link below a smaller kit. That is like the little sister or the little brother to this kit, because the average person's not going to use this. Some of this stuff looks like hatchets. Like, I know what to use it for. It's just like, when am I going to need it, though? You know what I'm saying? So look for that down below. Without further ado, I'm going to take all this stuff off, put my little pajamas on, my house shoes. Girl, let's get into it. Fire flip. She's a boss. She's a bitch. I think that as a compliment. I've been trying not to go off the deep end. All right, Diamonds, it's been about 5 to 6 weeks since the last time I gave myself a pedi. I wanted to make sure that there was enough dead skin cells, enough roughness, etc., that needed to be removed, and so that you could actually see what I'm removing as well. Once I got the foot spa filled with water, and I do fill it just under the max full line, just to take account of things that I'm going to add to it, I turned on all the elements, the heat, the bubbles, and the massager. To get this concoction started off right, I grabbed a lavender Epsom salt and I poured about maybe a fourth of a cup in. Then I decided to drop in this tea bag full of goodies. It has oats, flowers, petals, some more Epsom salt, and even green tea. All right, Diamonds, now it's time to soak your feet. But before you sit down, make sure that you have everything that you're gonna need to relax for about the next 20 minutes. Like your phone, some wine, maybe play some music, burn some candles, you know, whatever you use to relax. But now it's time to put your feet in, so go ahead. Just be careful, the heater's definitely very hot. It works very well in this unit. I started off, once I put my feet into the water, massaging them just by running my feet back and forth over the massagers at the bottom of the unit. Keep in mind that if you do have athlete's feet, any type of fungus on your feet, anything like that, you can add apple cider vinegar to the concoction, and that definitely aids by killing that bacteria. Diamonds, so I'm just gonna hang out, chill, listen to the rest of this interview, because Diamonds, if y'all ain't watched the interview, Megan is serving hot tea. You hear me?
15 minutes later.
Pulling one foot out, I'm going to pat it dry. I like my toenails short, and I cut them last night out of habit, so I'm just filing them down to make sure they're even and smooth. Then I grab my stainless steel cuticle pusher. I prefer them over the wooden ones. I think they just work a little bit better for me.
keep in mind, Diamonds, I do the same thing to the other foot, just off camera. Now I'm going to cut my excess cuticle, which this does take practice to get used to. It's kind of weird doing yourself. It's kind of awkward. So it'll take you a few tries, but you'll get the hang of it. To help slow my feet, I grabbed an exfoliating gel and massaged that in gently a bit. Then I took a pumice stone and concentrated on my heel, the side of my foot, and then the bottom. Next, I'm going to shave these unsightly hairs. And for that, I grabbed this shave butter. It's the absolute best. It makes my skin super, super soft. And it's from the Dollar Shave Club. It gives me the same quality shave and vibe as my Harry's, but it's quite cheaper. So if you're in Wally World, it's definitely worth a try. Next, I dried both of my feet and I cleaned under my nails and applied my moisturizer. And now I'm ready to paint my nails diamonds. This footrest is a game changer. The link is below. Check it out. You won't be disappointed. To prep my nails and remove any lotion or oils, I took a cotton pad with some alcohol and wiped it away so that the polish will stay adhered to my toes. And of course, the good old toe separators to keep those babies from touching. I used the Beatles brand gel polish, and I started with a thin layer of the base coat, and then I light cured it for 120 seconds. The gel color I used was also by Beatles, number 223, and it's like a burnt orange color. I place two thin coats and light cure them both for 120 seconds each. And diamonds, don't skip the top coat. And diamonds, these are the finished product. I give myself a pedicure every couple weeks. My mom always says, if you stay ready, baby, you'll never have to get ready. Keep your feet on point. Self-care is a must. Diamonds, as always, take care of yourself, take care of others, and until next time.